Hi, my name is Margaret. In this video, I'm going to introduce you to Java enums. Enums are special kinds of classes that are used when you need to represent a limited number of constant values. So let's start with an example. Let's say we have an enum called color, and it offers a limited choice of colors. So I make it public. I call it enum instead of class because it is this special enum class. The name is color. It has a body like every class. And it has a limited number of constant choices. In my case, this is red, blue, yellow, and black. Each of my constant choices is implicitly public, static, final. Public means I can access it from a different class. Static means I'm going to call it on a type. I'm not going to create an instance of an enum. This is impossible. You can't do that. And final means it's a constant. This is the reason why we use all uppercase letters for our enum constants here. So at this point, I'm going to compile, and I'm going to my color app to test it out. I prepared already my main method, and I'm going to declare a variable of type color. So here is my type. This is my new enum type color. I call my variable my color, and I assign it a value. We talked already that my constants are implicitly static, so I call them on the type color dot, let's say blue. Now I'm going to print the value of my variable. I say system out printf my color %s. Let's have a new line after that. And here comes my color. So I'm going to compile and run. And you can see my color is blue. So the way the variable color.blue is represented is with the constant name in all uppercase letters. I might also be interested to see what my choices are, and every enum has a static method called values. So I can look at all my possible values. I could say for each color C in color dot values, for each color in my color values, I'm going to print it. System out printf %s, and here comes my color, and then I'm going to add a new line at the very end. System out print line. And I can see my choices are red, blue, yellow, black. At this point, I have the most simple version of an enum. But in Java, enums can do much more than in many other languages. I can use it just to declare a limited amount of constants. But I can also add additional class members. And we're going to do that right now. So if I want to add more class members, I have to add a semicolon after my constants, and now I can add additional fields. For each of my colors, I would like to know the RGB, the red, green, blue component. So say I have a private integer red, private integer green, private integer blue component value. I also have a constructor that assigns each of my constants a certain RGB value. So here is my constructor private color. It has a red, green, blue component, and it assigns it to the fields. So here is red is R, green is G, and blue is B. Note that my constructor is private. Enum constructors have only two choices. They can either be package private or private. They must not be public. So here I have a constructor which is private, which means I cannot call it from my color app. And of course the question is, where am I going to call my constructor? And the way this is done with enums is right here next to my constant declaration. So as I declare my constant red, I also add what are the RGB values. And my arguments here have to match the parameters specified in my constructor. Now, for those of you who are familiar with the RGB values, I'm going to show you briefly how this looks like. Each color has associated red, green, blue value. So if it's red, it has 255, this is the maximum. The values go from 0 to 255, no green, no blue. If I'm green, or I'm lime, I have no red, all green, 255, no blue. If I would have a darker green, I have no red, no blue, but a little bit less of the green, not 255, but only 128. And so by combining my red, green, blue values, I can get different shades. So here I'm looking at my red value, so it's 255, 00, and I'm adding here 255, 00. Now I'm going to look up my blue value. Blue is no red, no green, all blue. Here's my blue, and I say no red, no green, all blue. Now we're going to check out the yellow. Yellow, all red, all green, no blue. This might be counterintuitive, but I'm not getting more into the RGB values here. This is just how yellow is represented. So let's say yellow here is 255, 255, 0. And black is no color. If all the colors are gone, what I'm left with is black. So I'm going to say 0, 0, 0 for my black here. At this point, each of my constants has a value for the red, green, blue component, but I don't see it yet. So I'm going to write a method that exposes the RGB value, and I make it public because I want to be able to access it from the outside. I call it RGB value, and it's going to return a string. And here I am going to create a string and return a string with string format. And I say what I would like is to have this parentheses, then my red value, green value, blue value, just like this, red, green, blue. And I'm going to compile. And now I want to test it in my color app. I have already a variable, my color, which is assigned blue. We printed out my color, and now I want to also print out my color RGB value. And once again, this is a string value, and I'm going to access it with a dot operator and RGB value, because this is my method name that I defined right here. So it said RGB value, it had no parameters, which means we call it without arguments. So let's compile and run. And I can see my color RGB value is 00255. And if I check back, 00255 corresponds nicely to my blue. So at this point, I'm quite happy already. There's one thing I don't like yet. It always tells me my color in all uppercase letters. And usually in English, we don't do that. So I would like to change this. I would like to have a first letter uppercase, the rest of the word lowercase. And the way I change this is by overriding the toString method. You can see here, I would just write represent as my color. I can do this with every reference type. By the way, in Java, every type is a reference type except for the 8 primitive types. So here I'm going to pass a instance of type color, and behind the scenes the toString method is called. Now the toString method for enum gives me the name of my enum constants, and I want to change this. I want to have the rest of the word in lowercase letters, so I'm going to override my toString method. Here I say override my annotation. I say this is public, returns a string, is called toString, so this is the signature of my toString method that every class inherits from object, and it has to return a string. I would like to take my original string, which was all uppercase, and then change the rest of the word to lowercase. So I'm going to start with my original string, and I just call it constant name, because this is what my constant name, this is what my original string was. The way I get my original string representation is by calling super toString. Now, this is a little heads up to inheritance. Super calls the implementation of the parent class. Now, how exactly that works, we are not going to discuss in this video, but that's what it does. So here, this super.toString gives me the original toString implementation, which was the all uppercase constant name. And now I'm going to change this. I'm going to return my constant name and only the first letter in the original. So they say, give me the substring from 0 to 1. And now I'm going to concatenate it with the rest of my constant name. By the way, there's a typo here. And this time I want to have the substring starting at 1 all the way to the end, but I'm going to transform it to lowercase. What I'm doing here is it says, give me the original name, take the first letter, then add from the original name the rest of the word, except for the first letter, transformed to all lowercase. Let's compile that. When I go back and I'm going to run my program, it just tells me blue, red, yellow, black. First letter uppercase, the rest in lowercase. This is it for now. See you next time.